In this video, I'm going to be showing you everything you need to know to find keywords that actually convert. We are going to be talking about keyword research. We're going to look at how much keywords cost, and I'm also going to show you how to know if you have a bad or a good set of keywords on your hands. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, watch this video. Now, if you haven't subscribed already, what are you waiting for, dude? Just like click that button. It's right over there. And also hit the bell button so that you can get notified every single time I drop a new Google Ads tutorial, which happens about twice every single week. Or every single week. Or sometimes I'm lazy and I don't do it and I know I'm supposed to do. Okay, I'm getting besides the point. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Button is below. All right, so now for the big question. How exactly do you know if you have good keywords or bad keywords? Well, to explain this, I'm going to break this video down into four parts. First part is going to be intent. Second part is going to be frequency. Third part is going to be cost, like how much do these keywords actually cost? Can we afford them? And last but not least, we are going to talk about how to put everything together in a keyword plan. So let's go. So the first thing I want us to talk about is intent. And to do that, we're going to look at the keyword or the keywords running shoes, okay? So running shoes, I know in other countries they might be called trainers. Okay, these things, the things you run in, that's what I'm talking about. All right, so running shoes. When we're talking about running shoes, and when somebody searches for the keyword running shoes, we need to look at the intent behind that. So what do I mean by that? We know that the person is searching for running shoes, but we don't know if they are a man, a woman, a parent looking for running shoes for their child. We don't know what exactly types of colors they're looking for. There's not much to go off of other than somebody searching for running shoes. So you can think of running shoes like a low intent keyword. There's not much intent behind it. Now I want you to look at a different keyword. Let's look at the keyword running shoes for women. Now, as you can see, just by adding for women, the keywords for women, there's much higher intent. We know already that it's a woman, she's searching for running shoes. And what that means is we already have a much better picture of the type of product or the type of service to show to her. She's a female looking for running shoes. So we can say, just by that simple example, that the keyword running shoes for women is better than the keywords just running shoes, because there's more intent behind it. You see what I'm getting at? But let's take it a step further. We know they're running shoes, and we know they're running shoes for women, but there are still a boatload of different types of running shoes that we can show to this woman to make her actually buy. So let's look at a keyword with even more intent. What if we go running shoes, or rather, what if we go marathon running shoes for women? Now, with that search phrase or with that group of keywords, there is massive intent because we know who the person is, female or identifies as female. We know that they are looking for running shoes, and most importantly, we know what they intend to do with the running shoes. So we know there's massive intent behind the keyword. So we can then clearly say that the keyword running shoes is a very low intent keyword, whereas the keyword marathon running shoes for women is a very high intent keyword. And I say keyword, what I really mean is a whole lot of keywords stuck together, but I think you get my point. Let's look at a few more examples. If I say, for example, web design, that's a very low intent keyword, because what do you mean by web design? Do you mean you're looking for free web design? Do you mean you're looking for e-commerce web design? Do you mean you're looking for responsive web design? Do you mean you're looking for web design jobs? It can be very varied and very broad in its meaning. So there's not much intent behind it. So if you were trying to advertise on web design, yes, you're gonna get a lot of traffic, but it might not be the type of traffic that you want. A better keyword with more intent would be something like web design for architects. Now, when you think about web design for architects, the person who's searching it in Google, they're already telling you who they are and what they're looking for. So the chances of us showing up and being able to fulfill that is much higher. And this is why intent is so important. The keywords are good that are broad, but sometimes they don't do the job and they don't give us the types of results that we hope to have with our Google ads because we're too broad. We're aiming at such a large cross-section that it's really hard for that person to identify if your service is for them or not for them. So the first part that we need to know is every single keyword that we use needs to have extremely high intent. Or rather, the best keywords need to have extremely high intent. All right, so we know exactly what high intent keywords are. Now we need to figure out how to use them, and that's where frequency comes into play. You could also call it search volume. So in a particular area where you're advertising, where you're showing your Google ads, those ads are only gonna trigger, they're only gonna pop up every time somebody searches for whatever your keywords are. Now, if you don't know how many searches are being performed in a particular area, it's gonna be very hard for you to figure out if you're gonna get a reliable source of traffic, if the keyword is searched enough. Now, to figure out how much it gets searched in a particular area, you're gonna need Google Keyword Planner. This will help you look at the search volume and it'll help you figure out how many times it's getting searched in a particular area. Because if it doesn't get searched at all, doesn't matter how amazing your high intent keywords are, your ad is never gonna pop up, your ad is never gonna show, and you are never gonna sell, and you are never gonna get that person to your website. So we need to make sure we have search volume as well. So log into your Google Ads account and I'm gonna show you how to use Keyword Planner. So as you can see, I'm in my Google Ads account, and then I'm gonna go to Tools and Settings, and I'm gonna go to Keyword Planner. Some of you might not see this because you're not in expert mode. What you need to do then is click on Settings and switch to expert mode first, and then you'll see Keyword Planner. Now, if you're still stuck and you still can't find yourself in expert mode, I've got a whole tutorial with 5 different ways to switch to expert mode, and you can check that out at the link in the description below. So watch that video, come back, and then continue this lesson over here. So we're gonna go over to Keyword Planner. And the cool thing about Keyword Planner is it allows us to see the stats of every single keyword that you can possibly add to your campaign on Google Ads. So sticking with our current example of web design, I'm gonna say web design over here. And I'm gonna say get results. Now, when I say get results, notice this column over here, it says average monthly searches. This is basically how many people in South Africa have searched for this keyword. Well, an average, well, we'll call it last month. So let's say 4,400 people have searched for that. Now I want you to notice what happens when I still say web design. Hold on, let's do that. I still say web design, but instead of South Africa, we're gonna go only for the state or the province of Gauteng. And I'm gonna say save over here. Now, did you see that drop? Only 2,400 searches now. That means these statistics are area specific. And this is what I talk about when I say you need frequency. If your keyword isn't getting searched often, that means your ad is not gonna show up as often as you'd like. So what you need is you need a balance. You do need high intent keywords, but you also need the low intent keywords as well because they complement each other. And somebody might ask me, yeah, but Devin, how do I know what's the average monthly searches I should go for? Well, it depends on your niche. I would say around about the 500 searches per month is your sweet spot. And then you would add your high intent keywords on top of that. So try and bear that in mind as well when you're doing your keyword research. So I want you to comment below and tell me if you're getting any value out of this video so far. And also any questions that you have, write them down below. I'll answer, I'll reply, and I'll make sure we're both on track. Moving on. The next thing that I want to talk about is cost. Now, you'll notice that these two columns on the far end, one says top of bid low range and top of bid high range. What that basically means is if we take the keyword web design, I'm just going to search for web design over here. If we take the keyword web design, you'll see these four
search results here, and they both and they all say AD next to them. These are actual Google ads, okay? So basically, when you see this low range and high range, this is basically how much people have paid to come into the higher range or the low range in the top four search results. So it's basically like a high-low range of what you can expect to pay for your keywords, right? So you gotta decide if a keyword is affordable for you. So I'll show you some expensive keywords. Like, for example, if we go to the United States and we say save, notice what happens to the cost of web design. Do you see? It's gone up dramatically just by changing countries. So that means that for selling web designs in South Africa, there's a very low barrier to entry and there's a very low barrier to getting clients. However, you can also look at different keywords. Like, for example, if I say car insurance, just to show you how out of hand this can get. As you can see now, my range has changed and I could pay up to $71, and that's for a single click. This is not to get a client. This is for one click on my ad. So I could expect to fork out between $17 to $71. And one thing that I want you guys to always bear in mind is that only about 3 out of every 100 clicks on a Google ad converts, because they've got about a 3% conversion rate. So it doesn't make sense to add a whole lot of keywords to your plan when you know you don't have the budget for it. Always try and go for keywords that you can easily afford. Otherwise, you're going to have one click and your entire daily budget is gone. You can also use the forecasting tool and you can figure out more or less how much your keywords are going to cost you, but I'm not going to get into it with this specific lesson.
All right, so we've covered the basics and now we need to add everything into a keyword plan. Now, adding everything to a keyword plan is pretty simple. You can just go onto your Google Ads keyword planner dashboard, add everything and name the keyword plan. But what I thought I'd do in this section is I want to cover a couple of questions that I'm always being asked by my students about keywords and adding keywords to the plan. The first question is, Devin, do I need to have only high intent, low cost keywords? Like, what about the broad keywords, the keywords that get searched often? Well, I would love to tell you that you can only populate a list with those high converting, high intent keywords, but the low intent keywords, the broad keywords, they also play a vital part in you building up a keyword plan. Now, I want you to think about it this way. Somebody might search for the word web design, stumble upon you, and still end up signing up for your product or service. Somebody might search web design architect and still stumble across your product and service and end up buying. We know already web design for architects is the higher intent keyword. However, it doesn't mean the keyword web design is completely worthless. All you do is you pay less for the keywords that are low intent and you end up paying more for the keywords that are high intent. And you add both of them, lovely thing what I did with my hands there, you add both of them to the keyword plan, and that's how you have a balance between having the broadness so that you can get the search volume, but also having the high intent where the best customers are. The next question that I get a lot is, how many keywords should you put into your Google Ads campaign? Like 500, 600, a million? How many should you put? Generally, I like to say that all of your keywords should be related to each other. It doesn't really matter how much you put in, but the sweet spot for me is about between 14 to 28 different keywords. Obviously, everything related to one another, and makes sense that somebody would search all of them together as well, or somebody would search those types of keywords and I'd group them together in an ad group, and I'd have one targeted ad with my heading and every single piece of my ad copy directed at that specific keyword. That's what I would do. It's up to you how you want to structure with your keywords. Some people like to go less, some people like to go more, but I generally keep it between 14 to 28 keywords. The next question I get is, Devin, where exactly do you find new keywords? How do you know when to add new keywords? Well, simple thing you can do is just go to your search terms report Google Ads, and in your search term reports, you'll see the searches that people did to find your product or service, to find your ads, and also you'll see the conversion rates on those search terms, and that'll help you get an understanding of what type of search terms to add or what types of keywords to add. So it's a great tool. For example, I have a free masterclass where I teach Google Ads, and one of my leading search terms is actually Google Skill Shop. Now, I'm not a part of Google Skill Shop, but when people search for Google Skill Shop and my ads show up, they end up converting for my masterclass. So what I did is add Google Skill Shop as one of my keywords, and now I know that I'm gonna get conversions off a keyword that I didn't even think about adding, which is pretty cool. Another way to do it is to think about your customers' pain points. Whenever somebody has a problem in their life, sometimes they never search for the solution. I'll give you an example. Somebody might not search for electrician, but they might search for something like my stove does not switch on, or they could search for something like electrical fault in building. So those would be good keywords to target because your competition is definitely not targeting them. Remember, there's a whole journey that the customer goes through to find out what the solution is to their problem. As business owners, we generally sell the solutions, but we forget that our clients are not aware of what the solution actually is. So it's important to you to figure out what pain points your clients have so that you have that nice broad range of search terms that they can get to you and your product. So if you enjoyed this little breakdown on keywords, I want you to sign up for my masterclass. Now, I teach you how to make your Google Ads more profitable. And who wouldn't want that? So if that sounds like something that you would fancy, I want you to check out the link in the description below. And it's completely free, so make sure you sign up and I will see you there. Lastly, I just want to say thank you so much for watching to the end. I really appreciate you. Make sure you comment below and tell us what other types of Google Ads videos you want to see, because I'm always looking for new content ideas. And lastly, if you want to figure out which video you should watch next, you can check out my whole Google Ads beginner playlist over here. And I'm going to put another video over here that you might enjoy as well. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Oh, by the way, my name is Devin. Peace.